the past, many researchers of the problem. And so the world is full of results of this kind. Strangely enough, the cognitive scientists don't take into account this problem. So they are unaware of the existence of this possibility.
Right?
I was interested in all the points of convergence that we make for yours, all your general concepts. I agree with you. And then towards the end, you brought in emergence, which is implicit in what I said, and top-down causation. Basically, you've been doing computations which develop the ideas, and the well networks again fit in. Possibly also your toroidal networks, agreement with the circles that led to the army corps.
I think one topic which was possibility of showing it here. Some time ago, I studied a particular system, which is a neuron, only one, which inside the microtubules, inside are a number of microtubules. And so, I included a correlation, no correlation, and an influence in the sense that the microtubules with their activities can influence the neuron external potential, the electrical potential, the membrane potential of the neuron. And in the same sense, the activity of the microtubules, which are inside the neuron, are influenced by the global neuron membrane potential. And so I left the system work. What happened? The inside system, the microtubules, were based on quantum probability calculus, were not classical. What happened is that there is both an influence. I measured an influence of microtubules on the neurons, on the whole neuron. And at the same time, the whole neuron was influenced the behavior of the single microtubules. I measured to the transfer entropy. And there is an effect, which is very, very interesting. The effect was manifested in the fact that I left the neuron without external input. And without external input, the microtubules were able to exit the potential of the whole neuron without external input, input coming from outside. This is interesting. And see, if this is true, it is possible to conjecture that in some way our mind, which influences the single neurons existing, can influence the neurons. At the same time, the neurons, through top-down causation, influence the microtubules. So it is possible to say that our mind can influence the single microtubules. It is possible. Not impossible. In principle.
Peter?
So, when you talk about the